Good evening, everyone. And welcome.
Oh, and welcome
to the Night of Percussion. My name is Tom Ongst. I'm the percussion director in the district, and I'm also the assistant band director here at the high school. So I see some middle school students way over there. You guys want to come over here? Yeah, come on. You can see the high school. Come in the middle here. We got plenty of seats here. So tonight you're going to see the high school concert percussion ensemble and the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade ensembles. I'm excited. We've been working really hard since January to work on these concert pieces, and I know the middle school, they're nervous. I could tell, right? But they're going to do a good job tonight. So tonight's proceeds are going to go towards the indoor percussion going to World Championships next week. We leave Wednesday morning at 4:30 a.m. That's about a 16-hour bus ride, so we're excited. We have a strong group, and I'm excited to get out there and see how we do with the competition. So, all right, so let's get started with our high school. This is a full concert piece that we're going to play. It's called Millennium.
Thank you. So I got here in 1992.
I know I don't look that old, but I've been here 32 years. And so one of my goals when I got here in 92 was I wanted my students to be a well-rounded percussionist. So it just wasn't okay to play snare drum, quads, bass drum. I wanted them to experience the different percussion instruments you see here. So tonight you're going to see students, they might play the marimba, they might go to the snare drum, and they might go to the timpani. It's all about being as well-rounded as you can as a percussionist. These next two pieces we're going to play for you are what we call chamber pieces. And that basically means there's less players on a part. Sometimes there's just one player on the part. So the first piece is A Taste of the Classics. And it's going to feature our freshman and sophomore students. And then our second chamber piece is called A Flight to Turkey. It's an advanced piece, which will feature our juniors and seniors.
Thank you.
was Abby Moore on the xylophone back there. Abby,
nice job. Mr. Susan, just in time. Did you know there was a concert tonight? All right, you brought your saxophone. You want to play with us? Come on down. Yeah. Mr. Souza, the middle school band director. All right, we're getting ready for our last high school percussion piece here. This piece was written for a friend of mine. His name is Lalo Davila, and Lalo writes a lot of percussion ensemble pieces that we play. He's the percussion professor at Middle Tennessee State, and he's getting ready to retire. So one of his grad students wrote this piece. It's an advanced piece. It includes a lot of different parts. It also includes the winds over here, and I asked Mr. Souza to sit in. We didn't really plan that he was just going to walk in when he was going to do this, but it actually worked out pretty good, so thank you. Yeah. I was going to tell a couple dad jokes. I know, I got some bad ones. Jason's up there going, no, don't. All right, so you ready for this? This is Lollapalooza, and it's dedicated to Lalo Davila. Thank you. All right, Mr. Sue, you get out of here. All right. All right. So, high school percussionists, let's head back, get change for the indoor show. Eighth graders, are you ready? Come on down. Give us a minute here, we're gonna get set. All right, we're looking for the guiro, so give us another 30 seconds here. Got a lot of stuff here. So while they're looking for that, this eighth grade class, we have a number of students that are participating in the indoor that you'll get a chance to see in a little bit. They also participated in the marching band. So if you're a parent of an eighth grader that has not participated in the high school and you want your child involved, it would be great. The door is open, so if they didn't this year as an eighth grader, as a freshman, again, the door is open. I know sometimes it can be intimidating when you watch the high school and you're like, wow, does my student or does my son or daughter have the skills? And that's yes, 100%. Myself and Brandon Carita, who played bass here for us, we write all the music for the students. So we're very accommodating and, you know, I know what skill levels that they have. So I'd like to see more students next year and pass around to the winds as well. Okay? All right, so do we find our guiro? We did. Awesome. All right. Okay. So this next piece is entitled Mi Cha Cha Pa Ti. It is actually by Lalo Davila. That's what I was saying. The last piece that we played was a tribute to him, and this is his one of his pieces. This is Mi Cha Cha Pa Ti. Thank you. All right, our next selection will feature three of our eighth graders. And two of the eighth graders, we have Dylan and Max here. Raise your hand, guys. They're in the high school already playing in the indoor percussion. And next year, Gavin's going to play in the high school percussion. Yes. All right. So this is entitled 3x3 plus Mr. Angst. So, seventh graders, are you ready? Did you hear that? They're like, yes, let's do this, Mr. Angst. Seventh grade, come on down. Thank you. Okay, so one thing I want to mention is the students, when they come up here, this is the first time they play on these instruments if they haven't been in the percussion at the high school. So it's a little bit intimidating sometimes. They do have professional instruments, but the sizes of the bars are a little bit different. So sometimes it's a little scary when they come out here. Plus the height of the marimbas, we have to adjust a little bit. So, all right, this piece we played about 3 weeks ago. It's a challenging piece because there's a lot of different percussion sounds that go on. It's not so much the playing that's hard, it's the counting before you have to play. So here is March of the Aardvark. All right, well, I think we have wait a minute, the sixth graders. Oh, six, we saved the best for last. Sixth graders, come on down. Okay, so the sixth graders have only been playing for about 7 months. In the past, we used to start the beginners in fourth grade, and then we went to fifth grade. This year, we decided to go to the sixth grade just because of logistics and space at the elementaries. I personally like it because we see the students every other day for 52 minutes, and they get to, instead of playing on their training instruments, which they have at home, they can transfer to the real instruments a lot quicker. So, all right, so we have three pieces that they're going to play from their book. One is the William Tell Overture. Second is Ode to Joy. And then we're going to rock out and do Rock This Band. Thank you.
mom wanted me to play the trumpet or the flute.
Know how to play all these percussion instruments. But they did a nice job, right? Middle school students, awesome. Okay, if you give us about 10 minutes, if you want to go to the bathroom out there, we're going to kind of reset the stage and perform our indoor show, okay? Thank you. Okay, while we're finishing getting everything set up here, I do want to thank some people that really, this is just not me. Actually, the concert stuff that you just saw, that's just me in class, but the indoor show that you're going to see, where we have a staff that I think is probably one of the best in the country. A lot of us have been together for a long time. So I want to thank the technical staff, people that kind of help teach the students how to play at the high school here. We have Brandon Carita. Yep. Ariel Enos. Ian Gorman. Lucas Higgins. Jocelyn Jerome. Dave Mills. Dan Monty. And Mark McGuire. Some of these students, or some of these teachers, have come out of the program, so it's really nice. They graduate and they come back and they help. So it's been awesome. I also want to thank the design team. We have Darcy Youngst, we have Brandon Carita, and Jeff Sacktick. And our music secretary, who really keeps things going behind the scenes, that's Kathy Banville. Our director of music, Mr. Ian Flint. Mr. Flint left a couple days ago and drove the truck for the Color Guard, because Color Guard World Championships are today, tomorrow, and you talking to me? Oh, I thought I did something wrong. The Color Guard Championships are today, tomorrow, and Saturday. So he's out there supporting the Color Guard. I also want to thank our custodians. Yeah, you can clap for that if you want. Our custodians, led by Richard Pereira, who I know is their cleaner right now down in the school. And I definitely don't want to forget these people. The parents that are just about here as much as the students. So this stuff in the back here just doesn't, we don't buy that. We have to build a lot of that. And the person that does a lot of the, I guess, the design and building the stuff is Tim Enos. And I did see Tim. Is Tim here? Oh, it's back there. Tim was in the group in the mid-90s, and then his son played in the group, and let's see, your daughter is teaching. Yeah, okay. All right, so thank you. And all the other parents that have kind of been involved here with, I mean, really as much as their child here is at rehearsal, they come as well. Can you just all stand, please, if you've helped Amy? I see people, yeah. Laura, yeah. Bernice. I also want to thank the DSMA president, Amy Dion, and the executive board for their support financially. Thank you. And Peter Chase. Peter's over there. He does our audio stuff for us and DCTV, so thank you, Peter. And I do want to thank the students. I'm really proud of what, you know, I guess myself and the staff and the students have been able to do this year. Been here 32 years. I mentioned that earlier in the beginning. And, you know, it's a lot of work, but I enjoy it. And I tell people that what I do here is, it's who I am. It's my hobby. It's, you know, going to rehearsal is what I do. I got a couple more years before I retire, but I really enjoy seeing how far we can get this show and the students every year to a level which looks like professionals performing. So I'm really proud of this team. We have a strong leadership team. Upperclassmen that have done an amazing job, and I think if you have that in any group, whether it's a sports team or, you know, band, when you have that, it just makes it a lot easier for the staff. So if we could give a round of applause to the leadership. Thank you. Yeah. And so next week we leave, and I mentioned this too, we leave 4:30 a.m. So parents that are dropping off, you should drop off at 4 a.m. Okay? And it's about a 16-hour ride out there, but I'm excited to, you know, again, to see how we do from a competitive standpoint. We start this in December, so it's a long road to get to this point. So, all right, so this will be our last performance here in Dartmouth. Are you guys ready? You excited? I'm excited. Let's do this. Here is the Dartmouth Indoor 2024 Indoor Percussion Ensemble performing Gallery X, where art comes to life.
Thank you.
That's it. See you. Thank you for coming.